All right, welcome back to Robbie Minds. I have you with me, a very special guest of mine, someone who I'm a huge fan of, burst into the scene a couple of years ago and has continued to do amazing, amazing things in the Nigerian music industry. Lil Kesh. Mr. Miyagi. You have so many monikers now.
Yeah, Mr. Miyagi.
Mr. Miyagi.
Yeah, you already know. Young and getting it. Yeah. Afana, good to see you.
Same here, man. It's always, it's a pleasure to have you here.
Always.
I'm going to start with your glasses now. What are you hiding? What are you hiding behind? Why are you hiding behind them?
My eyes. Now, let's rub mine together.
So now the glasses are off.
Out, yeah. Face to face.
How's it going, man?
Like, man, I'm good. I'm good.
I just had a guest here who put me under pressure. This is like you were laughing at me then.
Yeah, because I was watching at the back and I was like, you know, when you that used to put people on pressure, that means so like five.
But he knows you.
Eh?
He knows you.
When I walked out now, he just.
He means he passes.
I mean, which kind of party? That you not graduated before you graduated. I'm sure it was at some party, reading book and partying at the same time, and he's reading one book. But he's a big inspiration.
It's a big inspiration. It's always nice to hear stories like that. But let's talk about you now. How's music treating you? How's Nigerian music treating you?
The industry is getting better every day. Let me put it that way. It's better than it used to be. Me, I'm okay. I give God all the glory. I dropped my album this year, Young and Getting It. The album did very well. It's still doing very, very well. I'm shooting videos of the album. So I'm just still in the business, you know. Yeah. And chilling at the same time. I mean, I'm about that guap world.
You've been in the business. How long have you been in the business for?
You know, it's a different thing when you're an artist and when you're in the business.
Yeah.
Big shout out to Olamide. He made sure he put all his artists through. We're not just in the music. It was more than just recording. He made sure we met the right people who were in the business. So I'll say I've been in the business since I got signed. And I got signed in 2014. So I'm like, this is the third year.
So before then, you were just doing music, but now?
Yeah. Before then, I was never in the business. But the moment I got signed, he started making sure I was meeting the right people and having my own direct link to them.
What's he like as a boss?
He's a brother. That's just the word for it. Everything you can think of a brother, he's a brother. So.
I want to talk contracts now, because in the last week, we've had so many issues, you know, with artists
and
contracts being, you know, thrown out the window and people being sued. And I'm hearing ridiculous figures, billions of naira that people are supposed to pay, you know.
And how much are you making for this music?
How does your contract, not going into details now, of your own contract, but how did your own contract work? How did it work with you? Did they provide a lawyer for you?
I had the best contract. I don't know about other people's contract, but the contract I got was like, it wasn't even a contract thing, because when Olamide called me, I remember he gave us a call. Okay, Victor, take your contract. Lukesh, take your contract. You guys could go through, you know. And then we go into discussion. We started talking again. Before I knew, I dropped the contract. I didn't even go through it as much. Although you should always go through a contract when you get it. Always go through a contract. But I didn't really go through the contract. And when we're talking, at some point, we didn't even know where the contract. See, today, I don't even know where the contract. Because Olamide built us up on
trust, more like.
You dig? It was more of a family thing. That was what it built us up on. Okay, I read the contract to some extent. It was supposed to shoot like 3 videos for me within the space of 2 years. He shot 6 videos for me. He did more than he was supposed to even do according to the contract. So,
Do you think you were lucky with who you dealt with? Maybe if you dealt with someone else and you didn't
read the contract in detail, like
you said.
It's just a blessing to me. Let me say I'm blessed, not lucky. I'm just blessed to meet someone like Olamide.
So my point being, for those artists now who are going through these issues now, what do you think they did wrong?
The basic truth is, this music industry, nobody is in it to help you. Everybody is geared to make one thing or the other. Everybody has a selfish interest. Nobody would look an artist now or a random boy that is very talented and be like, oh, I like this boy. Let me invest in him. Let me see how we can make the world a better place. Let me help him. They always want to have, like, they have more advantages to themselves than the artist. That's why they end up giving crappy contracts and giving crappy percentage. And it's just crazy. Nobody in this industry is really out there to help you. So for everybody that you are, there's probably someone that wants to sign you, make sure you go through your contract. It's not every day you meet someone like Olamide Badon.
I wonder why we're still having those issues now. Because we've had so many in the past. We had Vector a few years ago. We've had Brymo. It's been happening for a while. So what are the artists doing wrong? Because it looks like it's always the artists who seem to get in trouble. you know, with the contracts. Are the lawyers not
just,
enough?
Or don't you trust lawyers? It's just a breach, basically.
Are these contracts signed under duress? Like, do they tell you sign now? Don't take it home. Like, I wonder.
But like we all know, we are desperate in Nigeria. Most artists that you see now, before they got big, at some point they were very desperate. I was very desperate. I mean, if I saw someone that would give me a 90 to 10% stage then, where there was no other person that is even looking at me, I mean, you probably might have taken it. That's the level of hunger that street boys have, you dig. But, I don't know. But then, eventually, then you get what you've been wanting, then there's more responsibility, then you need more than you're getting, then you end up breaching the contract. Well, that's what happens.
Yeah.
I thank God my story wasn't like that. I mean, within the space of 2 years now, my contract ended, and Badu as a visionary, I mean, he's just a visionary leader, you mean. Yeah. I mean, he already had it all planned out. He made sure I worked as hard as I could, so in 2 years, I'm strong enough to stand on my own.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to sign artists that he will come and make them slaves under him. He wants to sign artists that after a while you'll be like, oh, yeah, go. You two can sign other artists. So those other artists you sign can sign other artists and make the world a better place.
So have you started your own label now?
Yes. Yagi.
What's it called?
Yagi Records.
But you're still sort of affiliated with YBNL.
Yeah,
so how does that structure work?
YBNL is still my management.
Okay.
Yeah, so I mean, Badu is my other brother. You can't. Business or no business, family is family. I can't be like my own younger brother is my official DJ, so I can't say because of business now at some point I just chase him away. He's still my brother, you think? So Badu is the one I will still call. After Badu, you know, the thing say, no, shoot this video. I'll be like, oh, yeah, shoot, but what you want to try? I think you should try this thing. Even when I have things to start out in the industry, he still makes the calls for me. Controls Lil Cash. Lil Cash controls Yagi. So if Olamide controls Lil Cash, basically Olamide still controls Yagi. He's wiping out Yagi.
So why not just stay in the contract then? Why end the contract
was over.
Years? So why not renew it if you're still going to be affiliated with him?
But there was no point. At this point, make sure I'm strong enough to stand on my own. Now the mission has changed. Let me put it that way. The whole thing has changed. Now it's not about Lil Cash being under YBNL to make more money for YBNL. Now it's about Lil Cash having something of his own and is making money to help other people.
Yeah.
You understand? I mean, Badu already signed another act, you know. We have a YBNL princess now, her name is Temi. So it just goes on and on. I mean, at some point, Adekunle Gold himself needs to make the same decision. He needs to go and, because, I mean, someone believed in you, someone picked you up, and now you're who you are today. It's only right for me to do the same thing. It's only right for Adekunle Gold to do the same thing. It's only right for every other artist to do the same thing. Let's just make the world a better place.
Good stuff. Let's talk about your music now. And I try to wonder what to call you. Are you a rapper? Will you call yourself a rapper?
Yeah,
or what genre of music do you do?
I dive into anything as long as it sounds good. I love music. So I don't really even see myself as that kind of artist. I'm an hip-hop act. The reason I'm here today is because I recorded some bad hip-hop song that made Olamide believe in me. I mean, like, lyrically, that song is my breakthrough song. It got me my record deal, you know. So I'm an hip-hop art up to date. When I still vex that I want to go and rap, yeah, I'll go to this genre. It's not like I don't have rap songs, but I don't always have to drop them. But at the same time, I understand the market. I know what my people want. People see Lil Cash as a Junzing guy, I mean. So they see him as someone who makes them happy with his songs. Club, in the club, you're turning up. At parties, you're turning up. Feel good kind of songs. Either is Afro or Afrobeat or reggae. Let's just give the people music.
Yeah. I like what you said there about, you know, giving people what they want. I asked about rap also because people have said that two of the purest forms of music from like the 80s and 90s are almost dead now, rap and R&B. Because of all the influences from pop
people are bored.
And all of that.
I don't know about the Yankee market though. I don't
know
about
boring.
Rap is still selling up to
you.
R&B
now.
Yeah?
R&B in America is even dying. There's so much pop has been influenced by, I mean,
trap music and all.
Yeah, so.
But those things are crazy. Those things are more, you can move more to that. Is less, I don't know how to put it, but okay, let's leave the Yankee market. Let's come to the Nigerian market now. Baba me, people are bored. People are going through serious things. Fuel is 145 now.
They just want
at times I'm driving around, I see people walking in this hot sun. At the moment I stand down from my car, I'm like, damn. This sun is too hot, and some people are walking under this sun 24 hours. So are you telling me this guy that worked on that sun the whole day wants to go home and put some serious rap music in his ear to listen to. No, I want to feel good. I want to buy a bottle of beer, then play me Efe Joko or play me Shakiti Bobo. Let me feel good. That you know what people want. There's no point giving them what they don't want. People want to turn up. Almost all the Nigerians now want to turn up. You see a 90-year-old, 80-year-old woman dancing Shoki. Dancing Shakiti Bobo. Why they are people want to have fun, so give them what they want. Me, I understand the market, I understand what people want, and I'm going to give you what you want. So me myself, I can make a good living for myself. I mean, what's the point being an artist, being popular, having a success story, and there's no money to back it up? I need to take care of my parents. I need to take care of myself.
Do you think money is too much of a factor these days? I mean, I see your peers.
But everybody needs to
flaunting it on social media, and it's almost like a competition these days. Who has more dollars on the bed?
Okay.
Who has more bottles
but,
pops?
But that's not my case, though. You never see me. Never see me flaunt money or flaunt my car. No, I don't think it is. Actually, if you are not doing that, you are even standing out, because almost everybody's doing it now. That's why I'm not the type that I want to show you I'm on a yacht. Even if you don't know how many times I go on a yacht and go and just go and chill on the norms. I don't always have to show you that I'm here, that I'm doing this, that I'm doing that. For me, it's not like that. I'm a reserved kind of person. I don't like
Your music doesn't say that.
That's why you barely. I know. My music says otherwise. That's why you barely see me. Chains and all. Nah, I'm cool like this. Let my music stand for me. That's what you guys are messing with. The music, you think? Yeah. So yeah, I mean. But then you're very right. It's a big thing now. People show you on. People show you the amount of cars they have and all that. I don't think it's very important, but still, it's good PR. It's good PR for the business, because we are different. We are celebrities. People want to see. Why are we different? People want to see us do things that are different from what they are doing, the kind of life they can live. I mean, a normal person would just buy a car and it's good. He doesn't really need to buy a big car. But celebrities, that's why you're different. They want to see you buy, live the life they are not living, swim, go on a yacht thing, just do what they are not doing. So it's good prayer at the same time. But me, my music is quite good for me. And I mean, my IG page and all that, people relate to me. So I'm cool. But don't be surprised, though. At some point, I can vex and travel to Malaysia or Dubai, buy gold and all that. It's just depending on how I feel.
We're going to go on a break now. When we come back, we'll try to talk more about your album, your relationships. And maybe we'll try to get you to drop a few bars about maybe Nigeria's economic situation.
That will be hard.
We'll take a break now. We'll see you guys in a moment.
Let's go.